Hey guys, what's up? So the Samsung Galaxy Note 20 is coming and it's going to be the fastest Android phone of the year with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 865 Plus. You see, generally the Galaxy Note gets the same chipset as the S device launched before it, but not this time. We have evidence from a Geekbench result of a device with model number SMN986U with a single core score of 985 and a multi-core score of 3220. These scores are better than the Galaxy S20 Ultra's with the biggest jump in the single core score. This makes it the highest Geekbench score for any Android device and hence makes the Note 20 Plus the most powerful Android phone of 2020. Also, developer Max Weinbach was able to dig into the code and find out that the highest core frequency of this SoC is 3.09 GHz, while the Snapdragon 865 has a clock speed of 2.84 GHz. This makes it the first phone and in fact the first SoC to have a clock speed of over 3 GHz for a mobile device. The phone also had only about 8 GB of RAM, which is strange since the Snapdragon variants of the Galaxy S20 series had 12 GB of RAM, but this might be a test device, so who knows. While there is little evidence why Samsung is changing its strategy, but in my opinion this may be done to create some difference between the Note and the S line. Over the years the difference has diminished and Samsung would want to give the device something more than just the S Pen. You see, even OnePlus does something similar where the first flagship has a normal SoC while the T version has a plus variant of the same SoC with some minor upgrades. That being said, there is not a lot of difference between the two versions except the clock frequency and some minor improvements. We also have a Note 20 Ultra case mold leak from Roland on Twitter. We can see that the cutout for the camera unit is pretty big and we can assume it's going to have the same camera as the one on the S20 Ultra. Moving on, we have information that Samsung is facing the heat due to its decision to use the Snapdragon SoC in South Korea. You see, South Korea is the home market for Samsung and they developed the Exynos chipsets there and they still haven't used it on the devices being sold in that market. While there might be a few reasons for that, one of them is that the performance from the Exynos 990 wasn't satisfactory even after multiple evaluations. And since 5G was critical for Samsung's marketing strategy, they had to go with the Snapdragon variant. We just hope that Samsung fixes this mess ASAP and comes out stronger with the AMD graphics in 2021. Samsung has also reportedly ditched its custom CPU division entirely and will license ARM's designs going forward, just like Qualcomm. The company is also working on a 144-megapixel camera sensor. This comes from Sudhanshu on Twitter, who adds that this might be first seen on Mi 10S Pro or the Mi CC 10 Pro. The Mi CC series is what the Mi Note series is known as in China. So outside of it, we can see it as the Mi Note 11 Pro. We also had rumors that Samsung was working on a 150 megapixel camera. So this sensor might be the same with the final resolution at 144 megapixel, producing 16 megapixel pixel bint images. Sony and Samsung both are also working on over 200 megapixel camera sensors. So the megapixel war seems to have just started. And finally, we have some bean news. No, this is not a cooking channel. We're still making tech videos. We're just talking about the latest Samsung Galaxy Buds, which are codenamed beans and kind of look exactly like that, like a bean. If you know, the Galaxy Buds Plus actually had the codename Popcorn, so this makes sense. These are gonna have two speakers and bear the model number SMR180. They also have several microphones for improved audio and maybe active noise cancellation that was missing on the Buds Plus. The shape on these is quirky and we'll have to wait and see if or when Samsung ever decides to launch them. Let's move over to a fruity rival, Apple. The new $399 iPhone has got its name and it's going to be named the iPhone SE. So no iPhone 9, just iPhone SE like last time. There were rumors that they might call it the new iPhone, but we saw it on Apple's own website yesterday and since then it has been removed. You can see that this phone doesn't look like the iPhone SE at all, so we can assume it's the new iPhone SE. That's it for this video. If you have any suggestions or feedback, leave them in the comments. Also, tell us what features do you want the Note 20 to have. I hope you have found this video useful. If you did, please consider subscribing to the channel for more such videos. I'll see you all in the next one. Till then, bye-bye and stay safe.